Hello, vinyl community. Bradley here. Just have a few albums to show you. I made a little trip this weekend, or this past weekend, so I'll tell you about it a little bit. Actually, last Thursday, I decided to go up to Cleveland, and then on Saturday, I plan to go to my niece and her family in Youngstown. So anyhow, on the way to Cleveland, Thursday morning, I stopped in Findlay, Ohio, which was right on the way. There was a record store there that I wanted to stop at. I think it was called, Retro Records, I believe. A very small store. They had, the records they had in there were really, really nice. No filler. And they had, they probably had a couple hundred used jazz albums in there, which is one of the reasons I stopped in there. So I picked up probably 7 albums for like $42 or so. So that was good. First album I'll show is I've been into trying to get original Impulse releases lately. So I ran across this and picked it up. This is in fantastic shape. It's a Shirley Scott Trio. This was, I think, 1964. So it's called Great Scott, Shirley Scott Trio. On side one, it's got the orchestra is conducted by Oliver Nelson. So it's got the really nice laminated cover, and the album cover and gatefold is in fantastic shape. So I was really excited to pick that up. I've got a few albums that Shirley appears on, usually with her husband. At the time, Stanley Turrentine. I will show the actual record, which is in fantastic shape. Original Impulse. This is stereo. So is the original stereo release. So I was very happy to pick that up. Okay, the next album, you cannot go wrong with this artist. It is Julie London. This is called Whatever Julie Wants. This was probably 1961, I believe. The back has some water damage or whatever. This is in mono, and it's got standards on here, such as, it has a few Cole Porter songs, My Heart Belongs to Daddy, and also there's another song on here called Daddy, written by Bobby Troup, which was her husband. He was a jazz musician, and Bobby wrote the song Route 66. Get Your Kicks Out on Route 66, and they starred together in Emergency, the TV show, later on in life. So I was happy to pick up a Julie album to add to my Julie London collection. Okay, the last album I will show before we get into story time is, and this album I was not even aware of. It's on Atlantic. It is Les McCann and Eddie Harris. I think this is from 1969, and it is on Atlantic Records. This was recorded live at the Montreux Jazz Festival in Switzerland in 1969. This is live soul jazz. It's really good live soul jazz. And kind of like the story behind this album is that the people at Montreux Jazz Festival, they recorded, of course, probably all the groups. And anyhow, Atlantic wanted to buy the tapes for this, for Les McCann and Eddie Harris. So they paid $100 for this tape. You can't go wrong with that. And actually, I think one of the songs on here was a gold record status. I think it's called Compared to What. It's kind of like a, I guess you'd call it a protest song from the 60s. It was covered by other artists. I think Roberta Flack did a cover of it. And Les McCann actually sings or spoken word, more of singing on this album. So, sounds excellent. Like I said, I was not aware of this album, but this is good stuff. I'm really glad I picked that up. So, on with the rest of my weekend, because a lot of it was music related, so I'll tell you about it. Like I said, that was Thursday. Thursday evening, I had tickets to a showing of the latest Blue Note documentary. What was it called? Something about The Last Note, I think. But it has been in a limited showing at cities across the country for the last month or two. And I think actually the DVD is available right now, I think. So, I went to see it. It was at the Cleveland Institute of Art over on the east side, University Circle area. And they had a nice theater, large screen, great sound system. So it was like really cool. Talked to a few people before the show and got to know them. And so we went in and watched. Fantastic documentary. I would highly recommend it. Kind of like told the history of Blue Note, more or less. I think I had interviews with Rudy Van Gelder and Alfred Lion and Francis Wolfe, co-founders. Also Herbie Hancock, Wayne Shorter, Robert Glasper interviews. And it brings it up to current day, where Blue Note is still releasing some groundbreaking records. Some of them are a little more hip-hop, but very good. So, that was Thursday night. Went back to the hotel. My plans for Friday was to go downtown to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland, downtown. And I also thought maybe I'll just stay downtown and go to the Indians game that night. Well, anyhow, I went down to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, which is very cool. If you're ever in Cleveland and you have some time to spare, I would highly recommend going there. They have lots of exhibits, interactive music, and things like that. And actually the last, I think in August and September, their feature exhibit was photography by Jim Marshall, the photographer back in the 60s, and it is centered on his Woodstock photos. So that was very cool. And they also have like a huge, it's like really large gift shop. They have got everything in there. Anything you would ever want to do with rock music. And they actually had a lot of records and CDs in there. The prices were a little high, you know. They were even higher than, a few bucks higher than normal retail. Although they did have some really nice box sets with vinyl and CDs that you don't normally see in person at record stores. But and they also have like an area where they have guitars and drums and keyboards set up, vocal mics, so people can go in there and kind of jam around. That was on the fourth floor. And I went up there and there's a lot of teenagers up there, and but it was pretty cool. So anyhow, I decided I didn't want to hang around downtown and wait 4 hours to go to the Indians game. I thought, I'll pass on that. So I go back to the hotel and take a little nap, and I have a text waiting for me when I woke up. It's from a very good friend of mine. We played together in several bands, and he said, "Where are you?" I texted back, "I'm in Cleveland at the hotel," which he had recommended this hotel. He goes to a lot of Indians games. So I said, "I'm in room 331. So I get a text back from him. He says, "Well, we are in room 333. Right next door, on the other side of the wall." So I go over there and knock on this door, no answer. So I give him a phone call, and Terry said that he and Susie, his wife, were at the RTA train station, which is only like 200 feet from the doors of the hotel. It's just a very short walk, and you can jump on the train, go downtown. So and he said, "Do you want to go to an Indians game?" I said, "Give me 2 minutes to walk over to the train station." So I walk over there, we ride down to the Indians game, have a nice meal, go into the stadium, and they had tickets on the first base side. And I didn't have any tickets, so I thought, well, I'll just buy a bleacher seat. I love the outfield, great seat. And we knew there were storms in the area, so we made plans that if in case of rain, we would meet at a particular bar in the stadium. Well, it went two innings, which was great, and then it started lightning and thunder and downpouring. So we met up and hung around for maybe an hour, and it became obvious they weren't going to start the game up again. So we went back to the hotel, and this postponed game, they were going to play 1 o'clock on Saturday afternoon and have the normal game at 7 o'clock later that night. So Terry and Susie, I knew they were going to use their rain checks and go to that first game. But I had plans to go to my niece and her family in Youngstown. So I left for Youngstown that morning. Got down to Youngstown at Jenny's probably around noon. Spent the day with them, and then stayed there that evening. Slept there. So and came back on Sunday. So very enjoyable weekend. A lot of it was music related. I bought those albums, went to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and watched the Blue Note movie. So it was a very, very nice small getaway weekend. So that's about all I have to say. I'll show some of the other records I got later this week in a video. So I'm shooting this in the park just down the street from my house. So, okay, I'll catch you guys later. See ya.